The Team Lally Show was previously recorded.
It's time to enter the world of real estate in Oahu with Hawaii's only true real estate radio show, the Team Lally Real Estate Show. Grab a pen and get ready to take notes. For the next full hour, Hawaii's premier real estate leader, Adrienne Lally, and Attilio Leonardi will bring you the latest in real estate news and real-world strategies on how they can guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it. Now, here are your hosts, Adrienne and Attilio.
Welcome to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. If you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com. Okay.
For about a second.
There All right. Go. We've got it. Attilio.
I have to get my glasses.
Oh, get those glasses.
I have to get my glasses. Well, actually, you know what? No, I don't need my glasses for this. So, here's a quote from William Blakely. Joy and woe are woven fine. I'll say that one more time because people have to, like, you know, with these, it's not in a syntax or in a style of talking that we're used to. So, and plus you might be driving or doing something else, maybe half listening to us. So I got to do it again. Joy and woe are woven fine. And this is a quote from William Blakely. This was from a podcast that I was listening to. It was called Hidden Happiness. And they also, something else that I wrote down was a Chinese parable. And I don't know if it was Chinese. We just, you know, they're like an old civilization. I guess we'll be older than the Chinese Egyptians.
Yeah.
She could just pick one of those two. They've been around a long time, and then she can pick one Egyptian. Well, it's a Chinese parable. There was a farmer, and he ended up getting a horse. It was a wild horse. And it was a wild horse that he got to use. And so the villagers thought, oh, wow, how lucky. And then the son was riding the horse, and he broke his leg.
Mm.
Now, what do you think? Lucky, not lucky?
Not lucky.
Well, here's what happened. The army was coming around conscripting. What is that? What they call that for Vietnam?
Drafting.
They're drafting young men. But back in those days, conscripting the son, and he would have gone off to war and most likely died. But he couldn't because why?
He had a broken leg.
So he didn't go off to war. And what this psychologist talked about is sometimes, you know, it's a perspective of ways we look at things. And sometimes the worst thing is the best thing.
It's about reframing.
Yeah.
We learned about that over at our journey.
Sometimes, all life events are neutral. Mm-hmm. The only meaning that they have is what we assign to them.
That's right.
You know, so if it's a horrible situation, we assigned that meaning to it. If it's a joyous occasion, we assign that meaning to it. So sometimes the worst things are the best things. Hedonic adaption. A lot of stuff here on this first couple minutes of the show. So I'm trying to entice you all to tune in early and buckle in.
Take some notes.
Get your pen and paper, just like the promo says in the beginning. Get ready to take some notes. There's an obsession of how things are versus we have an obsession of how things look versus how things feel. And that was actually a quote from Megan Markolis. You know who Megan Markolis is? She's an American actor. We don't say actors and actresses. We just say actor. Gabby PC. And do you know who she married?
No.
Prince Harry.
Hmm.
And she's like, the point that she was making is she was like, she wanted to go out to lunch with her friends. And they said, there's too much of you is out there. So we can't allow that. And she said, I hadn't been out of the castle or whatever, where they live, the prince and the queen, out of the compound in two times in 4 months. But they were not allowing her because everything is, you know, they call it the firm. That's the inside. What they refer to the royal family is that, you know, hey, just like in the Disney movie, right? I married a prince and now I'm a princess.
Mm-hmm.
And just that was a quote from her. There is an obsession with how things look versus how things feel. And she's actually lonely. So people look at her and think, oh, you know, it was a wedding that probably a lot of people watched. It was very idyllic. And, you know, you're married to the royal family, future heir to the throne. But that's how things look. And what's more importantly, as we go through life, is how do they feel? It doesn't matter what kind of...
And she feels lonely.
And she feels lonely. And there, I bet you there's a lot of people out there because of this pandemic. So we're realizing that it doesn't matter what kind of cars you have, what kind of house you have, what kind of things you own. How do you feel?
How are you feeling?
How are you feeling?
How are you feeling today?
Yeah.
You know, one thing that we learned about the reframing.
Yeah.
How are we feeling today? I'm on fire.
Yeah. We learned that from, what was his name?
Dan Lear.
Dan Lear. He said, and people ask you, how are you doing? You say, I'm on fire, baby. And you just walk away. And they're like, okay, that person's crazy.
Or excited or on fire. Yeah.
Then they'd be like,
excited to be alive.
Well, he said he did that at a convenience store or whatever. One of
the airport.
And the lady's like, can you come back again tomorrow?
Come back tomorrow.
I need more people like you in the line to buy stuff for me.
So speaking of awesome people, we've got Bradley Mariama.
Yeah.
On the line to talk about his insurance tip of the week.
Yeah.
Bradley, what do you have for us this
week?
What
you got for us, Bradley?
How's it going?
Always great.
No.
We're on fire.
Yeah.
We're going to go over a term commonly used in insurance. It's called deductible. So what does the deductible mean?
Yeah.
In layman's terms, basically, it's what you're responsible for paying prior to the insurance kicking in. So typically, on a homeowner's insurance policy or a condo HO6 policy, it's a $500 or $1,000 deductible that most people will opt in for.
Mm-hmm.
So if there is water damage, you pay the first $1,000, and then the insurance pays the rest. For hurricane coverage, it's often done as a percentage. So if your house has a $400,000 replacement cost on the structure, and there's a 2% deductible, that means your deductible is $8,000. So a storm comes through, a hurricane storm comes through, you're responsible for the first $8,000. Now, the reason why I talk about this is I just had someone that lives along a golf course, and he went up to check on a pipe on the roof and noticed that three of his PV panels one golf ball didn't crack all three panels. It's three separate incidents.
It was three individual terrible golfers, not one terrible golfer.
Yeah. So what happens is now, if he wants to fix each panel, it's three separate claims, each time $1,000 deductible. So
yeah.
At that point in time, initially he wanted to file a claim after understanding that it's three different incidents. He says, oh, it wouldn't make sense because my deductible is $1,000 and each panel is worth $1,000. So, you know, it's just very important, like we always say on this radio show, to review your policies, understand what you have. It's also important to understand the definitions of the terms of what you're covered for. So this week, the term deductible is what we're covering.
Yeah.
An excellent explanation, Bradley.
The deductible.
And I love the story just to bring it all together.
Well, the real life example.
Yeah.
You know, there's unfortunately terrible golfers.
Mm-hmm. I've had some terrible golfers that cracked my my panel.
Yeah, and they don't come up to your fence and put a note saying, oh, I'm a terrible golfer.
Yes.
I broke one of your solar panels. Maybe can you call me so I can take care of that?
They don't
do that. Nope. Unfortunately.
Yeah.
So our big advice is to get Bradley and his team to review your policy. Make sure that you are properly insured.
Yeah.
You know, based on your goals.
Well,
and your
home. What you should do is, what do you think? They should take the deductible, put them in savings or, you know, some kind of investment. So if they need to use the deductible, they have it.
Mm-hmm.
And you pay less on the premiums. But if you're paying less, you got to know that trade-off when it comes time to filing a claim.
Know the numbers. Bradley will go over them with you.
Yes.
It's important.
Okay.
Thank you, Bradley.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Bradley.
Thank you.
All right, so you can get a hold of Bradley and his team by heading to our website and clicking the resource tab, and you'll find him under Experts We Trust.
Yeah, two people that I'd recommend go call up Bradley and his team, realtors and mortgage brokers.
Yes.
Yep. He's great to work with because he has a team too.
He does, and he can be reached at 591-8016. Have him help you review your policy. Make sure that you are not over or under insured.
Yeah, it's important.
Right. So next up, we've got Kyle Shimoda from Impact Wealth Solutions with his tip of the week. Kyle, what do you have for us?
Hello. I would say Delaware statutory trust. So always something good to have in your back pocket if you own investment property and looking at ways to maybe get out of the management of it and maybe retire from the active managing of investment property. So DST is a way where you can do a 1031 exchange into like-kind real estate. So it can be other properties that a DST qualifies, and it's fractional ownership in institutional quality commercial real estate, like an Amazon warehouse or a office building, a large multifamily project, things like that.
And I'm currently an owner of a DST in a storage facility. It's very exciting.
It's, you know, I think of like owning investment real estate, you know, with all the hassles. It's like you make money every month, but you get a spanking. And with a DST, you make money every month, but you get a hug.
That's right.
So what you like?
I get hugged every month. It's so like takes all the stress away. Just the money just shows up.
I love that.
Yeah. Yes.
I love that. I tell you what, I got lots of spankings from my investment properties. I want more hugs this year.
Yeah, what's a spanking? Oh, we got to clean them again. What's another spanking?
You got to evict the tenants.
I've got spanked with a refrigerator went out, leaky.
They didn't pay the rent.
Sink faucet. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All sorts of fun stuff.
Yeah.
So there is a DST webinar that's coming up. I believe it's on October 21st. So if any of our listeners want to head on over and learn a little bit more, see some real life examples and have their questions answered, they can head on to teamlallydst.com and sign up for that next webinar.
But any more questions for Kyle? No. Kyle, give us what's the most recent offering for a DST with that you've had a client invest in? What's the most recent one? Or two.
We've had some grocery and some 7-Eleven projects which have done very well, and I hear there's an Amazon coming around right around the corner in about a week or two. So just
distribution center,
and it's the Amazon distribution center on the East Coast. It's going to be one of their high quality large facilities.
Now people are like, well, why would they have us little investors own the building that Amazon is and they're worth billions? Why don't they own the building themselves?
Mm-hmm. You know, I had that same question. Yeah, it's a very similar model that Amazon's doing that Walmart did. You know, they're in the distribution business, so they're not in the real estate business. Mm-hmm. So they can make more money by Amazon will buy the property, they'll build the building exactly to their specs, then they'll turn around, sell it for a couple million or hundreds of millions. They'll take all that capital, then they'll go do it again with another warehouse or buy more inventory. So they just want to lease back the property that they built for themselves.
Yeah, their ROI on a dollar is better spent with on building another distribution center, like you said, you know, buying more inventory than it is in the building that houses the distribution center. Where it becomes a win-win is you as a property investor owner do a 1031, you get to own a piece of the building that Amazon's in, or a 7-Eleven, or a grocery store.
And it's through the DST that you get to be part of that. So,
and has there ever, you know, with all these offerings through the company that researched, because there's a lot of research, right? Have you seen any that didn't have return or cash or?
Cash calls. Has there been any cash calls that you've heard of?
Cash calls, capital calls. Well, there are many DST sponsored companies out there. Yeah. We work with the best, and my broker dealer is very conservative, which I love. So we work with a number one DST sponsor, and they've been doing real estate for over 50 years. They've been doing GSTs since GSTs were allowed back in 2004, and they've never had a capital call ever.
Now, we know that, we know that current history is, or past track records are not an indication of future, but that is a factual statement. They've never had a DST investment that didn't grow and or pay income. It didn't go negative.
Mm-hmm.
No, and they've done 120 of them so far, and they have 13 going full cycle this year alone.
Yeah.
There's other DST companies that haven't even gone one full cycle. So
be aware. Be aware as a consumer.
What people are like,
They're not all the same.
We're hearing this all the time. People are like, it's too good to be true. No, we didn't put a man on the moon by winging it. There was a lot of research and experimentation and more research and more data was taken a look at. That's the same thing these guys are doing. And it's not even anywhere as difficult as putting a man on the moon. It's just making sure that it's a solid investment, because there are tons of industries that do well no matter what the economy is doing. And that's the ones that they will help you invest in.
Okay.
That's it.
Thanks, Kyle.
Hugs or spanks, spankings, what you want.
Love it.
Okay. So head on over to teamlallydst.com and sign up for that next webinar, or you can sign up to get more information just with the one-on-one with Kyle.
Next up, we have a mortgage banker that makes you feel good, just like a hug. She works hard for you. We got Jody,
the mortgage genius Pacific Rim Mortgage, with her tip of the week.
What you got for us, Jody?
Hi, today I wanted to talk about things you should know when you're meeting with a lender.
Yes.
And this is where this tip comes from, is actually we did a signing for a buyer that is buying one of your guys' listings.
Mm-hmm.
And they got referred over to us by the amazing Howard from Team Lally.
Awesome.
And they, you know, had been working with the same lender for 6 months. And they, when I talked to them, because they had been working with their lender for 6 months, I said, listen, no worries. I'm just going to get your information, show you what we can do, provide some information. We can have a conversation and take it from there. You don't have to leave your lender. Let's just have this conversation.
Yeah.
And so they were like, that sounds great. And, you know, she's a police officer. She works really long hours. Well, I guess her shift was the daytime, so she wasn't available till like 7 o'clock at night.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, so a day after I collected their information, we met up and did a Zoom at 7:30 PM. And I went over, I did my normal consult. I said, you know, this is a maximum qualification. This is based on the property you want to submit an offer on. And these are the key points that you should know. You should know what your monthly payment is going to be, including maintenance fees. You should know what your interest rate is. You should know if you're paying points. You should have an itemization of all of the fees associated with the transaction, not just what are defined as closing costs. And you should know the total amount of money that is needed out of your pocket.
Yeah.
And so anyways, that was about a 35-minute Zoom. And she said, where do I sign?
Yeah.
You know, and I said, this is great. I'm so happy. And she was a first-time home buyer, and she said that she had worked with three different lenders, specifically being with the last one for 6 months, that no one she talked to had taken the time to really what we call the deep dive, but go in and hash everything out in terms of this is what you can expect, and it's all, you know, just on one slightly confused. It could be confusing if you're just looking at it for the very first time, but that's why we walk you through it, one comprehensive document. And so we just signed them today, and it was less than a 30-day close, and it was a really feel-good one because, you know, when she first called me, she was like, I don't know why I'm calling you. I'm just, they told me I should, so I am, but I already have my lender. You know, she kind of had her guards up a little.
Yeah.
And the end result was a win-win-win, which is they were super happy because they got a better deal. They closed faster than they would have been able to close. They, you know, you guys, your seller, I'm sure, was happy because we closed early. It was all just, and she just felt really, what it came down to is she just felt like she had so, she was given so much information.
Yeah.
She got educated. She wasn't just like, she's along for the ride. You actually explained things.
This is from the MBA, Mortgage Bankers Association. Something like 87% of consumers don't even talk to another lender.
Mm-hmm.
And that makes no sense whatsoever. This is like a decision that's going to be with you for the next 30 years.
Mm-hmm.
You should jump around. And so why, Adrian, why do we put it in all our listings that and or we have this conversation with our sellers and we say, we recommend that if an offer comes in, that they, we recommend that they get a
pre-approval from Jody and her team.
And why is that a win for the seller?
Well, Jody and her team, they do an extensive deep dive, yeah, as she was explaining, with the process and the client's financials, credit check, verifying to make sure that they actually are qualified, because it would be terrible to get into escrow and the buyers start spending money, the sellers start making plans, and then lo and behold, oops, you know, we didn't calculate this one thing that we missed because it wasn't.
And we've had this happen to us.
Yes. More than once.
Sellers.
Yep.
We're trying to close and we can't because we're going with the buyer's lender, or not the buyer's lender, but the lender that they brought to the table with their offer. We're just saying, hey, you know what? Jody, correct me if I'm wrong. If the lender that they have has a better deal, you'll tell them.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And she has. There's been other times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
And there's been times where I've said, I'm going to be completely transparent with you. I don't think that they can honor this.
Yeah.
However, if they can, it is better than what I can do. I think you should stick with them.
Yeah.
And there has been times when they've come back and they're like, okay, it changed. And that's because, yes, you talked to them 3.5 weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
So things change. And it's hard to... Oh, it's hard to know as a buyer, especially a first-time home buyer, when so many people are giving information, auntie, cousin, your trusted agent, your friend that has an agent, best friend, I mean, and your most, you know, if you're talking to different lenders.
Yeah.
But it is difficult. It is not easy. But that's why I feel like having someone that is communicating with you regularly, someone that can answer questions quickly and put your interest first, all that stuff matters. Someone that's going to take the time to break it down, and you say, I don't understand. And we say, okay, let's back it up and then start from here.
Well, that's all good news.
Yes, excellent. Yeah,
take a break.
An excellent tip, Jody.
Thank you Jody.
For sharing that success story and for things that consumers really need to know about when they're sitting down with the lender.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So you can get a hold of Jody and her team at 488-5510. You can also find them on teamlally.com under the resource tab on Experts We Trust. All right, so we are going to take a short break, but stay with us. When we come back, we'll be talking with Duke Kimhan of Hawaii Pacific Property Management. We'll talk about the questions you should ask when hiring someone to rent out your Oahu investment property. Stay with us.
Hey, it's Dina Hollyfield with Royal Ride on Country 97.5. And I gotta say, my friends Adrian and Attilio of Team Lally will really go out of their way to sell your home. Just ask Matthew and Marsha Wharton. They were responsible for selling a family estate in Laie'e by long distance. They weren't even here. Team Lally hired landscapers, a handyman, and painters to get the home ready, plus arranged to sell their truck, a motorcycle, and many other items. Talk about going out of your way. Team Lally received multiple offers and sold the home above asking price. Even as an investor, Matthew told me this was the best service he's ever received from a realtor team. Even if your home needs a little bit of work, don't pull off selling while the market is hot. Call Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally Real Estate Group of Keller Williams, Honolulu. Call 799-9596. That's 799-9596. And tell them Dita sent you.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you. In Hawaii, I would hire Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi. Their marketing strategy is so effective that if your home doesn't sell on terms you agree to, Team Lally will buy it. Partner with the team I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
The Team Lally Real Estate Show continues.
Give it to me, I'm worth it. Baby, I'm worth it. Welcome back and thanks for listening to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. I'm Adrian.
And I'm Attilio.
And if you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Hey, before we bring on our awesome guest we're about to introduce in a minute, we just got a quick tip from
American Floor and Home.
Chastity. Hey, Chastity, are you there?
Hi, I'm here. Thanks so much for having me again. Yeah.
What's your quick tip this week?
Okay, quick tip. So everyone wants to save energy, and especially right now, the pricing of electricity has definitely gone up. So definitely having great windows is a plus, but not just putting curtains or blinds to help cover up your windows for privacy, but definitely thinking about using honeycomb cellular shading or shutters for your windows. That helps keep the warmth that you have in your home, especially when it gets cooler outside, and keep the temperature that you want it to be in here so you don't lose energy having to turn on ACs or, you know, try to keep your home a little bit warmer.
Yeah, I think that's a much more passive way to conserve energy than the other ways. Plus, yeah. Your neighbors cannot tell if you're wearing your goofy pajamas in the daytime.
Yes, and I wear goofy pajamas all the time.
Yeah, I think Adrian has Pikachu with the foot, the footies and everything, the foot coverings.
So American Floor and Home also does window coverings is what I'm sensing here from this tip.
Yeah.
Well, good one.
Yeah. Hunter Douglas. Yeah. So cellular shades, honeycomb is great for insulation and also shutters.
All right.
Window shutters. Yeah.
Thanks, Chastity.
Yes. Thank you, Chastity. Oh, excellent tip this week. Yes.
Yeah. Awesome.
All right.
So where can we reach you at?
Yes, so we can reach Chastity at American Floor and Home at 271-9671. You can also find them under the resource tab on teamlally.com on the experts we trust.
Our guest today was born and raised in Honolulu and grew up in Manoa Valley. He was first a restaurateur. Before delving into the world of real estate, he was a chef slash owner of a fine dining establishment in Florida. He was a general manager of the year for TGIF and owner proprietor for Outback Steakhouse.
As a real estate broker, he specialized in investment properties, condos, military relocations, 1031 tax exchanges, and commercial properties. He is currently the principal broker of Hawaii Pacific Property Management. Please welcome our guest, Duke Kimhan.
Hey, Duke.
Wow, who is that guy? That sounds like a pretty busy guy.
Yeah.
An amazing guy with a wonderfully...
awesome accomplishments.
Yes. A very diverse background. And here we are.
All started in Manoa.
That's right.
All started in Manoa. That's right. Went to Stevenson and up to Roosevelt. But right after that, you know, we started... I got my real estate license when I was 18.
Oh.
Stapleton, School of Real Estate. That's how long back it goes.
So you always had that real estate license going, and then you were doing the other things, and then you eventually circled back around to this is it, real estate.
Well, property management came about after I was in the sales side for almost 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
And then I figured out that I was already doing some property management on the side, mostly concentrating on sales. But someone came along and said, you know, if you concentrated on just property management, your property management side would take off.
Yeah.
And when I really did some research on who was actually out there doing property management, there was a very, very small amount of people who strictly did property management.
Yeah.
And so it didn't take long for our guarantees to really take effect on the market. And still till today, in island of Oahu, I can't speak for the other islands, but I don't know of any other company besides our company that does guarantee their work.
Yeah.
So that's a big deal when there's real estate salespeople like you guys who have guarantees. Mm-hmm. Like, we guarantee this, we guarantee that, we guarantee that if we don't do this, we'll pay you this.
Yeah.
There's nobody on the property management side who actually says, we guarantee, you know, these things.
So speaking of these guarantees, Duke, what is the guaranteed rents?
Yeah.
What is that about?
So the rent guarantee says that if we will tell you upfront what the lowest amount of rent that we could get for your place, and we are wrong on that, then we'll pay you that amount of money upfront. Well, that one's not as big as the eviction guarantee. So that's number two.
Yeah.
The eviction guarantee states that if we do all the background checks, we cover everybody, we ask how they're doing, what their paychecks are, we verify all that stuff, and we end up having to evict them, and we'll pay legal costs to do that.
Yeah.
So if owners are doing their research, they should ask other property management companies, if there's an eviction in my property, who pays for that?
Mm.
So now, if you use us, then it'll be us that pays for it.
Yeah,
so Duke, maybe you can share a quick story, because I remember this particular situation about an owner that really wanted to place their own tenants and they had to be evicted. So, you know, share with our listeners the dangers behind that.
Well, family or friend or person that you work with, those are the worst tenants that you can allow. Because one thing is that the eviction guarantee doesn't carry out. Mm-hmm. It doesn't guarantee it.
Yeah.
The second thing is that, you know, when people say, oh, no, I'm sure they're fine, you don't have to do the background checks on them. Well, you know what? That's why you pay a property management for. You want the background checks. You want to verify that they have enough money in the bank account. Especially when friends or back relatives move in and don't put security deposit down.
Yeah.
And we get that question a lot. And I got to tell you that you are going to Vegas, pretty much. Just, you live in Hawaii.
Yeah.
You're gambling.
What kind of red flags do you see when you pull these background checks that eliminate a particular tenant from, you know, falling under this eviction guarantee? What are you seeing?
The biggest one is collections. Hmm. You know, they either went through a bankruptcy, a divorce, or they had to, you know, sell the house, or they're just in trouble and they don't make enough money. So let's just say somebody's moving to Hawaii and they're just getting a job for temporary because there's nothing in their field and they only make $2,000 or $3,000 a month. But the rent is $3,000.
Yeah.
That's not a good person to qualify in putting them in your house for $3,000 a month in rent. They may have good credit, but they have no income. That's a problem too.
Well, I know that.
So they get in trouble.
Yeah, they get in trouble. They're on their own. But if they get in trouble with you, at least you're there in the boat with them.
Hmm. That's right. And then the last guarantee is the communication guarantee. So I would say that, you know, every year we pick up 20 to 30 owners from having a property manager who doesn't respond to them.
Yeah.
I got a lady right now who says, I don't have a computer, but I have a phone, and my property manager has not called me back in 2 months, 3 months, after I called him almost every week.
And the phone works both ways.
It certainly
does.
Oh,
my goodness. I feel bad for her.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I asked her what the problem is. What was the biggest problem that bothered her that made her call us? And she said that nobody calls her back. Nobody lets her know. It's been 3 years and he's not even told her if her house is still standing. She lives in Washington State.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I think the challenge is, a lot of these guys are doing that plus everything else, right?
They're not focused.
It's not their main thing.
So let's talk about that, the focus.
Yeah.
Tell us about how you run this operation, Duke.
If you're not a full-time property management company, you're going to have a hard time understanding what you have to do to evict people. Right now, Bill 57 or Act 57 just started in late September, early October.
Yeah.
So if you're not concentrated and have legal advice telling you how it would go about and do this, then you're going to be doing it the wrong way.
So, dude, what is this Bill 57? Can you explain it briefly to our listeners? What does this entail?
Originally, House Bill 1376 was the cry from the governor stating that the eviction moratorium was going to be until he shut it down. So House Bill 57 acted to stop the eviction moratorium and how we were going to go about falling into an eviction. What is the procedure for eviction?
Yeah.
And right now that's a 15-day letter that notifies you that we will notify the mediation center of the Pacific to try and get a mediation together to get that going. But you have to be a minimum of 4 months late of rent.
Wow.
So there's all kinds of stuff that you have to follow. You know, this was started by Representative Nakamura, and he put out what the 15-day letter will look like. It has to be posted in a conspicuous place. So there's a lot of stuff that's going on right now in property management.
Well, that more,
and it changes. It's well, it
validates
changing.
That, and correct me if I'm wrong, Duke, that Hawaii favors the tenant.
Mm-hmm.
It does, and you know, the problem that we have on top of that is even when we have a mediation agreement done, both parties have signed it, it does not enforce the tenant to do what they said they were going to do, which we had half of the mediations go the bad negative, where the tenant says, oh, I changed my mind, I'm not going to move out, or I haven't made an agreement on the amount of payment that I was going to make.
Yeah.
So now you got to go back to court. You got to go back to court anyway, and you got to start again with the eviction.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's really tough. It's a lot tougher now to be an owner than it was just a year and a half ago.
Well, you know, and I want to talk to you. You were reminding me of I had family, and it was my dad was renting to family. And this is not distant family. This is pretty close family. We said, hey, we're not going to live in the house, but, you know, we'll rent it to you guys. You know, you guys are having, you know, some challenges. All you got to do is when the mortgage payment comes, just make the mortgage payment. So not even making money on it.
Mm-hmm.
So all of a sudden, my dad gets a notice like that we're in default. So we call our family and go, what? How come you guys aren't making the payment? I was like, oh, we thought we was just staying in the house. We was doing you a favor. And so my dad had to go through the whole thing with the sheriff. And it was just a big nightmare. This was 25 years ago. To this day, we don't even talk. We don't still don't talk to that family.
Hmm.
Unfortunately,
yeah, that's a good way to lose communication with somebody is give them a free place to live.
Yeah, and it was real nominal mortgage payment too. But it's like, oh, okay, you guys stay there, and then we're gonna go in foreclosure and lose the home. That does not make sense at all.
I don't see how that's a win for anybody.
That's what happens when you don't have professional property management screening the tenant.
So.
You know, when one third of our sales in Hawaii are investment property, that's a lot.
Yeah.
So, you know, each month there's 1,200 to 1,500 houses that are sold. And so you figure 400 of those are investment property.
Yeah.
So I sometimes get calls from the buyers who say, hey, I'm thinking about buying this property. What's it going to rent for? Or I get a call from an owner says, hey, I just bought this property. What can I rent this for?
Yeah.
So you can choose who's the smarter buyer. Do you call after you buy it or do you call before you buy it?
Yeah, and do that research.
Exactly. I recommend that if you're a real estate agent, that ask a property manager for free, what will I get for this client buying this property management.
Yeah.
The other thing that you like that you do and you advise the agents and the buyers as far as things that could be trouble. So, you know, speak to that. There's certain properties that you all won't take.
Yeah, tell them.
Without AC.
Yeah.
And without parking. So, if you don't have adequate parking or you have no AC in the property, it's really hard. The properties stay on the market for a little bit too long for us.
So, they're walking from far away because no more parking. They're already hot and sweaty. And then they get home and they're even more hot and sweaty because no more AC.
Mm-hmm.
That's called an upset.
That's a recipe for disaster.
First of the month, and then they get the rent due on the first of the month.
Yep.
Right. So, you know, another tough one is when somebody tries to rent out a part of their house.
Yes.
Like the garage is transferred into a rental, or it's a six bedroom house and there's a two bedroom, one bath in the back. And, you know, they're sharing the electric and sharing utilities, the water. These are really tough situations for an investor.
Yeah.
So I do not recommend, and I repeat this, do not recommend that owners include water and electric into the rent. You have to find a way to at least charge half of the rental or a percentage of the people on the water side and put a meter, a sub-meter on the electric.
Yeah, with today's technology, it's not that expensive or difficult. And
it's not.
It avoids a bunch of headaches, right? Because there's always a big argument. Well, you got that 50,000 gallon fish tank in your room. I ain't paying the water bill.
Yeah, and you know, we've had situations where somebody will just keep the AC running 24/7.
Yeah.
And or, you know, so I had a guy that was doing all the laundry for his company.
So lovely.
He had a laundry service.
Yeah, he got reimbursed because he was a garage guy, right? They would do an auto repair place.
Wow.
And, you know, their water bill was up $600 and the electricity was up about $500 too.
Holy moly.
So, you know, owners aren't thinking straight when they do that kind of stuff. You know, the other thing is that you get people who inquire about doing short-term rental.
Yeah.
And, you know, the law is about to change to make it short-term rental be less than 30 days or more than 180 days.
Yeah.
And when does that law go into effect, Duke? Because we had heard that announcement and thought, oh, there's going to be some shakeup here in the inventory.
Yeah.
Well, there's a big vote on it coming up, I think, by the end of this month. And most of the people are leaning to change the law and to make it, you know, Colina, Turtle Bay, or Waikiki in the only places that are going to be 30 days or less short-term rentals.
For the resort-zoned areas, that's it.
Resort, yeah. Some of them will be day-to-day. You can do a daily rental in that area.
But if you're not in those areas, what, minimum 6 months?
Yeah.
Minimum, you know, 181 months. Days. Yeah, 6 months.
Yep.
And what's
we don't handle anything short term anymore.
Yeah.
We stopped that about a year ago.
Yeah.
And what's the fine? Have they talked about the fining system if you're caught renting for less than 181 days?
Well, they can enforce you at $1,000 a day. Oh. That's the new law.
Wow.
Right? And so right now they're having all kinds of who said, she said in the government, but you know, they're talking about raising the TAT for the visitor tax to all the hotels, the hotel room tax. But, you know, there's so much going on right now. And there's a lot of things that are going to change soon because most of the government things are behind. They need money.
Yeah.
So they're trying to find a way, right?
Doling it out but not collecting it, and when it's all out and not too much in, you have a deficit. You gotta make that up somewhere,
right? Well, the city of Honolulu has an enforcement problem too, so they're trying to figure out what's the best way to say this is what you're going to get fined, and then how do you enforce it on top of that.
Well, I think the last big change was they attached us realtors to it, so if we were the ones advertising it, even if we didn't own it,
we were
liable for fines too.
Yes,
so they'll probably do that one again.
And then maybe with like the with the websites, right, with the Airbnb websites and the VRBO.
And so, I know they're talking about it, but I don't doubt that they'll increase their budget for enforcement, and they just have people sitting on the internet looking at Airbnb and matching up the tax records.
So, and then
it's not hard to enforce from that point on. But, you know, something that's also, I think that owners should be alerted by, that if you need any kind of appliance right now, and there's a huge shortage of appliances. Yeah. With all the backlogs that are going on, appliances in Lowe's and Home Depot and some of the bigger merchants are got nothing. And they're 6 weeks out right now if you even order an oven or range.
a dishwasher or a washer dryer. It's just been, it's tough all the way around right now.
Thank goodness I got my Costco refrigerator in the garage.
I
have a backup refrigerator.
Yeah, that's good. Now you just need a truck to go take it to where you got to go take it to.
Yeah, if my rental needs one, I got my Costco garage refrigerator just in case.
So what's the solution for that, Duke, with these back order appliances? If there's a tenant in place and the fridge goes out, like how do you guys deal with that kind of situation?
The second market on that would be like Ross Appliances. Mm-hmm.
And yeah.
All the
new stuff.
Even Craigslist. Yeah, yep. You got to go that way because you cannot have your tenant not have a refrigerator.
Got to have a plan B and C.
Yep. Right. And you know, the owners don't realize that the tenants, when they sign on for a rental, the rental doesn't say you have to have a, you know, $3,000 refrigerator.
No.
You just got to give them a refrigerator.
It doesn't need to talk to you.
A lot of them say, hey, this one's smaller than the one we had. I go, you should be happy you have one right now because there are none. They're out of stock. And when the stock gets put back in, then we'll give you a $3,000 refrigerator. But right now, be happy with the $1,000 refrigerator.
Maybe you might be thinking, oh, maybe I better get that garage refrigerator.
And I would just like to speak that Duke and his team are in between you as the owner or investor and the tenant. He gets to have those fun conversations with them, not you. So
they call you up and like, my Rocky Road ice cream went melt.
There's a lot of middlemanning, and that's what we do best.
Yeah.
So we have the best interests of the owners, but we have to try and treat the tenants as the most respect as we can, because if that was you that was in there, you cannot just say, hey, I don't have a washer dryer. I haven't had it for 6 weeks because you don't want to buy one.
You're always better. And tell me if this is true or not, but you're always better keeping happy tenants than mm-hmm. having to replace them.
That's right.
Yeah. Happy tenants make happy owners profitable.
Makes Duke happy too.
And they take care of the property also when they're happy. Right.
Well,
there's only two reasons why, you know, you would hire a property management. Is one, to protect your home first, mm-hmm. protect your investment. And two, the second one is to put money in your account. That's collect the rents.
Yeah.
And with a happy tenant, the tenant will pay rent.
You know, this
once they pay the rent, then you're half the way there.
Yeah. And here's what I would tell the listeners. Don't take our word for it. Go on Duke's site or just Google.
That's right.
Check out their
Hawaii
reviews.
Pacific Property Management. Google them. They've got an amazing amount of reviews on Google and on Yelp. And some of those reviews are even from happy tenants.
And you got, and you know what? Your guys' reviews is just like our reviews for Team Lally. There's a couple crazy sprinkled in there.
But more happy.
That's okay.
There's more 5 stars and more happy people.
This is what I tell people with the reviews. If my majority of the reviews are going to be like 4.9 above.
Mm-hmm.
But if they're all, every single one is 5.0, that's suspect.
Yeah.
So it's more like a 4.9 with a couple crazies sprinkled in. That's real.
Or outliers. They're like the outlier kind of situations. But I mean, I've run into several tenants on different occasions that have raved about being tenants of Hawaii Pacific Property Management. And whenever they have to move for whatever reason, maybe the
homes went.
They look for where else do you have available? I love how you guys treat your tenants. So
they're like Ford and Chevy. Yeah. They're like, I only buy Ford. I only rent properties from Duke.
Yep.
So, well, we've come to the end of our show. And if, again, the main guarantee is the rent guarantee, which is what, Duke?
Oh, so if we can't rent your house for the lowest amount of rent that we tell you in advance, mm-hmm. in writing, then we'll pay you that amount of money.
And then the most popular one is the eviction guarantee, which gives the owners that peace of mind, right? That tenant is,
right.
is gold.
You're like, the right? owner is inside the nightclub and you're the big guys at the front of the nightclub, the big bouncers between them and the nasty eviction stuff. And you're not going to let them inside the velvet ropes. You can take care.
That's right.
Yeah. While they're inside enjoying the nightclub. Property ownership without the headaches. All right.
So that's right. So you can give them a call at 445-9223. That's 445-9223.
All right.
Thank you, Duke.
All right. Sure. Thank you.
All right.
Take care.
And the website.
You can reach them at HiPacificPM.com. They're also under our resource tab on the Experts We Trust.
And by the way, all of my properties are managed by Hawaii Pacific Property Management. All two of them. I would have them manage my house, but I live there.
Oh, that would be a lot to ask to manage you and your house.
Yeah.
I want to, before we wrap it up, I want to read a couple of reviews.
Okay.
So we've got one from Michelle Rodriguez. The agent was Alicia. So thank you so much to Alicia and Team Lally. They did a fantastic job in helping us sell our home. We needed to move quickly and they made it happen for us. They were very efficient, communicative, and professional during the entire process. And we are very pleased with the outcome. Alicia went above and beyond and we are so grateful for everything she's done for us. We couldn't have asked for a better outcome. From the bottom of our hearts, thank you to Alicia and Team Lally.
Hey, you know, we talked about in the beginning of the show how there's way things look, but more importantly, how do they feel? And so I really, you know, I talked about a challenge or a problem, but I didn't give you like a solution. Well, how do we feel better about situations? Couple tips, and it's the basic stuff, but oftentimes we don't need to be educated. We just need to be reminded. Number one, get enough sleep. Number two, watch what you eat. And number three, get up and move your body every once in a while. All of these tips are at my website called getoffyourbuttanddosomething.com. I should get that website. People are probably, I don't have that website.
I think you did, and then you let it expire.
Oh, I let it expire. That's not a real website. Mm-hmm. You didn't figure that out. If you need help, go to teamlally.com. Just Google Team Lally. If you think, well, if you maybe you're one of these property owners has been a vacation renter and you're like, I don't want to deal with this anymore. I'm just going to put a long-term renter in there or thinking about selling. If you call us, we will give you both projections.
That's right.
What it would look like if you rented it long-term and what it would look like if you sell. We would give you both proposals.
Yeah. And then also I want to give you a reminder that we do have some open houses happening this weekend. You can head on over to TeamLallyOpenHouse.com and see all of the homes that we have available. We've got some brand new inventory that's just hit the market and some coming soon inventory. So,
by the way, if you're a baller and you need 16 acres up in Pupukea, go to PupukeaRoad.com. That's PupukeaRoad.com. It's at the very reasonable price of $5.9 million.
All right. Well, thanks for listening and thank you to our sponsors.
Jody Tonga and Derek Tonga, Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Bradley Mariama of Allstate Insurance.
Kenji Vendetta of Pillar to Post Home Inspections.
John Speed of Kilauea Pest Control.
Duke Kimhan of Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Kyle Shimoda of Impact Wealth Solutions.
Robinson DeVere of Fine Line Paintworks.
James Santiago of Kaji Cleaning.
Chastity Baisa Chan of American Floor and Home.
Jake Kisek of Skyta Construction and Roofing.
Broderick Sherwood of Zero Res Hawaii. If you want to get a hold of any of our sponsors, just go to teamlally.com.
We want to give a big thank you to Leah Rodriguez, our producer here in the studio.
Woo-hoo.
Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have an awesome guest talking about something that'll change your life
forever. This is the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the guaranteed
sold program. If we can't sell your home at the agreed upon price in a time frame, we'll have it bought for cash.
Thanks and aloha.
The preceding program was sponsored by Team Lally.